The Devil All the Time was directed by Antonio Campos and is based on a novel that tells the story of folks in a small town in both Ohio and West Virginia whose stories all connect through blood one way or another. First things first, I'm going to let you know that if you're going to watch this film, I'm issuing a trigger warning. There are sex crimes, a lot of violence, and an abuse of power every which way you turn. Just in case that causes anyone distress, I feel as though it's good to know that heading into this film. Alright, with that being said, let's get into the review. This movie is bananas. To be perfectly honest with you, I almost didn't finish it after watching the first act. And if I wasn't planning to review it, I probably would have just shut it off. It turned me off so much I had to take a break. One of the big questions I have with a movie that shows disturbing imagery and gruesome violence is why? What is the why of this film being made? What is the story? And at first, I just thought the entire film was just a series of extremely unfortunate events. But then in the third act, I began to connect the dots of the themes and found it to actually be kind of compelling. The structure of this film is pretty interesting in that it follows a bunch of different people who are connected by one person, the protagonist, Arvin, played by Tom Holland. And Holland does a really solid job in this film. I like him taking on a role so vastly different from his version of Peter Parker. Arvin is a troubled young man who's angry and has trouble finding peace due to the actions of those around him. The entire cast is pretty stacked actually, and they have three actors who are currently playing superheroes including Sebastian Stan and Robert Pattinson. And of course, that cast does a really good job as expected. But I will say most of the characters are not fleshed out three-dimensional people. The film has a lot of ties thematically to religion, and almost every character ties back to religion as well, which is fine, but it can almost seem to be a crutch to explaining them as people at times. I value character, and to just explain most of them as crazy people who happen to be religious fanatics seems a little bit lazy to me. But overall, while the film does have its flaws in its rocky first act and its at times fairly thin characters, I think it does present a pretty compelling crime thriller and is deserving of a positive score in my opinion. I'm giving The Devil All the Time the score of 6.5 out of 10. Alright, that about does it for the spoiler-free portion of this video. I'm now going to get into a very small and quick full spoiler analysis portion. To me, there's two ways that I interpreted the film. The first is a look at how people manipulate power. Some even use religious beliefs to act out their harmful tendencies, and aside from the school bullies and the sheriff, the most actively evil people in this film are quote-unquote devout believers in God. The other way I interpreted it is that perhaps The Devil All the Time refers to the direct conflict that Arvin and his father had battled throughout their lives from the war until the final showdown in Knock 'Em Stiff. Both Arvin and his father were in a vicious cycle of violence and death, and it was a losing battle until Arvin finally kills the sheriff and seemingly defeats the quote-unquote devil. Perhaps the devil is represented by violence, and perhaps Arvin never sustains any damage during these fights due to being protected by God, knowing that Arvin was enacting a crusade against evil, something that Arvin often says that he has no choice in. If you have any other interpretations of this film or the novel, let me know in the comment section down below. If you enjoyed this video, please leave it a like and subscribe for more Geeks Weekly content. I've been Kyle from Geeks Weekly. Stay safe and stay sweaty, my friends. I'll see you again next time.